It's not unusual to find spiders or bugs in your yard, just not one that large. The creator behind this wonderful sculpture and many others is Des Moines sculptor John Brummel, who is joining me today. John, thank you very much. Did you always start out to be a sculptor?
No, actually, I started out to be a steam fitter and learned welding in an apprenticeship. I've always drawn, but I didn't start metal sculpture till about 12 years ago.
Now, you started in wood sculpting, I understand. How did you make the transition?
Well, I did wood sculpture for probably 15 or 20 years, and after that, I taught myself stone sculpting and sculpted faces and heads in stone. And clients kept asking, but don't you do metal sculpture? And finally, it occurred to me that with the background I have, I probably should be.
Mm-hmm. You find recycled materials. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I am, I guess I was green before they called it that. I am a firm believer in reusing things, and I like the idea of creating sculpture from junk that isn't really obvious that it used to be junk. To transform it into something like my little friend here, I find incredibly exciting.
Now, you do commissions. Do you come up with these ideas, or do they ask you to do something for them specifically?
Some of each. Sometimes someone knows exactly what they want down to the dotted I and cross T, and other times it'll be something as vague as I'd like it to be contemporary and have something to do with nature, and just bring me some sketches and we'll get started.
Where do you get your materials?
Quite often people drop them off who would have thrown them in their trash, but Alder Scrap Metal, I've shopped there for years. And they all know me by first name.
Do you come up with a lot of these ideas, and are these for sale? I mean, how do people find out about this?
Yes, virtually everything's for sale. And I don't have a website yet, but I have a MySpace. It's MySpace John Brummel. I do art shows. I was just in the Iowa Sculpture Festival. I'll be in Metro Arts' Two Rivers show this fall. Actually, my yard is really a showroom. People come here by appointment quite often to view and purchase sculpture.
What sculptures do you like doing the best?
Oh, that's difficult to say. My interest is so eclectic. I go from very spontaneous rustic pieces to meticulous stainless steel elaborate pieces. And I guess the constant change is what I like the most.
Do you have a studio per se, or some place that people can shop, or is this it?
Well, I have a few pieces on display at Atomic Blonde, which is the upstairs of AOK Antiques in Valley Junction, and I have shown in several galleries, but mostly pieces are marketed at shows or right here in my yard.
What do the neighbors say?
They seem to find it very interesting. And, of course, I'm the guy in the neighborhood. When anything breaks, you can bring it to him and he'll weld it. So we have a good relationship.
What's in store for you next? Now, because you have transitioned from wood into all of this, what do you see down the road for you?
I have a new friend who is a glass artist, and he really wants to know how to weld. So we're going to cross train, and I'm very anxious to do metal pieces that employ rich, dark colors of glass.
Mm-hmm. All right, John, thank you very much. We'll look forward to seeing that.
Thank you.
Molly Cooney in the artist studio outside for KCCI News.
Well, you can get more information about his work by calling his studio at 515-314-2096. And John's sculptures will be on display and sale today at the 7th Annual Ryman Gardens Art Fair in Ames from 9 until 4.